Oh shit, it's already live. Okay then. YouTube changing the system. Alright guys. Let me go through the new stuff real quick. There's actually a lot of new stuff today. Most importantly, I think, is the zoom and pan, which we looked at a little bit last time, but it's been improved a little bit because now when you hold down, it zooms to the point. So let's say we hover our mouse over this point over here and then drag it, it will go towards that point instead of just going towards the middle, which is not as good. And then right mouse is pan, middle mouse is zoom, I think. There's also transparency now on the top. I don't know if we covered this last time, but yeah, there's transparency on the top. You can drag it out and it becomes a little fucking pop-out thing like this. So you could have your interface flipped upside down if you want now. For you crazy people out there. Alright, and then the other huge thing is we've got a new menu here called Canvas Size. So it's in the options hamburger menu and then Canvas Size, and it pops up here and you can do a lot of stuff. You can change the ratio here. You can change, there's a multiplier at the end for everything. And then also we have this little extend button here. So if I turn that off, now it kind of keeps everything scaled with the previous, like how it was before. And when you let go, you'll notice that if I hit OK, it's going to rebuild this at the current resolution. So it's much higher res here. And on the same note, let's say we're drawing like this little crab. You can go really high up and you can also go really down low. So let's say we're drawing something like that or whatever, and it has a teal background. And then we're doing high detail here, but we decide, okay, this is going to be pixel art now. We're changing the game style or whatever. So we're going way down to like 31 pixels. You can see the resolution down at the bottom. Say okay. Alright, so now we gotta zoom in. It's a little bit ridiculous, but there it is. Low res, and we can continue painting here. So yeah, we can do pixel art in heavy paint now. Let's go even lower. Let's see what the limit is. Ooh. I don't recommend going down to like zero or whatever, that's gonna explode it, but there we go. Okay. Now we are doing some really hardcore pixel art. But then you might think down the road, you're like, oh, I'm painting it, I'm making it different colors and shit, and now I changed my mind. I want to do AAA, like Call of Duty again. So let's go back, make it giant. Oh shit, now we're back to 8,000 pixels. And it retains all the goodies there that we just drew. So I hope that's blowing your minds a little bit. Where's my Windows ink bullshit happening again? There we go. Okay, the only problem is when you have super high resolution, we're at this canvas is 8,000 pixels, so it's a little bit slow. I'm gonna go back down to something more reasonable. And the beauty of this system here is that, as you can just, as we just saw, it doesn't matter what resolution you're working at. You know, we could work at really low resolution especially if you're working on a phone or some kind of shitty hardware. That's totally fine, because at the end, okay, let's say we're working really low res here on some sort of let's say we're working on a TI-89 or a Game Boy or something like that. Okay, we're doing our low res. The beauty of this is we can still use all of our fancy brushes and textures and everything, even though we can't really see the textures that well. It doesn't matter, because when you go to save this, when you export the image, you're gonna say, okay, test, let's just name it 01. We again have the multiplier here, so we can export it at 12,000 pixels if you want. Let's see if this crashes. I hope it doesn't crash. Let's see. So, I mean, of course, this depends on your device. If you have a, you know, depends how much memory your video card has, but let's go check it out. Where is it? Oh my god. This is 01, right? 11 megabytes this image is. Check it out. We just exported at 12,000 pixels. So, yeah, resolution is a figment of your imagination. Doesn't really exist. we're not limited by resolution here, guys. Anyway, hello Vedant, hello Hiram. Where can we get heavy paint? Check the link in the description. Hello Manu. Hi Twins. Hello Taken. So yeah, I'm excited about this update. It's a big improvement in just in terms of resolution, and we also have aspect ratios here. We can say I want to do Instagram square or 16:9 or 9:16. You can also do custom and, you know, set your own custom aspect ratio. But in this case, I'm gonna do square because I've been, you know, an Instagram person lately. And also, let's try to make the size a bit bigger. This is sort of ridiculous. Another nice quality of life thing now is, like, since Canvas has saved their resolution, you can change your page and it automatically fits the canvas to your window. So that's kind of a nice little trick now. All right, so now let's get back to some actual painting. But yeah, that's basically it. That's the new stuff. There was a bug also, guys, in Fill Poly, where it wasn't really working correctly, but that should be fixed now, so you can do Fill Poly. By the way, Fill Poly, I've kind of neglected it for a while, but it works with mixed colors now. So, you know, we can go here, then go to there. It's gonna mix between the colors underneath it. So that's kind of fun. Yeah, Carol. Okay, I'm excited to see what you do with the pixely version. Yeah. Tag me if you want on Instagram. I'll repost your pixel arts. All right, where are we? Teal. We're gonna give this little hermit crab. Can't go wrong with hermit crabs. There was also a bug in with the whatchamacallit, the color picker, the HSV color picker was not picking colors correctly, or it wasn't updating correctly, but I think that's been fixed now as well. Another thing too, it's pretty slight, but the random color recipe has been altered a little bit, so it's not so jumpy with the values. I kind of took out the value. There was a slight amount of value jitter, but that's been removed because I think it was getting a little too distracting. It's just too much. All right. Oh, one other thing that's been added actually just today is the stats have been overhauled and they're also much easier to find here. So when you click stats, it gives you the amount of each tool that you've used. So we got fill, draw, chisel, fill poly, and it also tells you the number of strokes, number of points, and this is new, the number of colors picked. So far we've picked 20 unique colors. If you do a bunch of strokes with the same color, for example, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these all have the same color, it should ignore the ones that have the same color. So there, it says 21 because we just added one new color. So that's kind of I think this is a nice tool to see. I guess you could tell, you know, how much you're changing your color, which I think is important for painting. I find that when I'm lazy with the colors and I don't pick too many colors, it starts to look kind of lame, or not lame, but a little bit flat. So I think that's a nice tool. John, yes, I know Yoon. I've worked with him a bunch of times. I haven't met him in person yet. I hope I get to meet him someday, but yeah, he's awesome. He's my brother from another mother. And Hung Chao says, fill lasso strokes disappear a lot. I noticed that too, that they were disappearing a lot, so this should fix that, hopefully. I changed the way the drawing works so that it hopefully doesn't do that as much anymore. I kind of like how janky and abstract this thing is. Where's Rake? Shortcuts. Yeah, there's a couple shortcuts. Actually, let me just show you. You can take a screenshot here. I just added this in recently, actually, so. Sounds dumb, but shortcuts were a bit of a pain to get them working with Windows and Mac, because, you know, Mac and Windows, they got Command and Control, and it's really annoying, but. Anyway, let's look for what are we looking for? Hotkeys. Let's see, input map. Okay, take a screenshot right here. These are all the shortcuts. So like key A is color pop up. Let's see what that does. There we go. It boops the thing to your mouse. That's cool. We have spacebar for eyedropper. Control Z. John, yeah, I worked at Insomniac. This was, I worked on the Sunset Overdrive game. I don't know when that was. 2013, maybe? Let's see. Oh, cool! We have Pi Menu fan. What is the hotkey for Pi Menus again? I forgot all the keys. Pop up? No. Pi W. Key W. Okay. In the future, this is gonna be all like you'll be able to customize that, but I haven't done it yet. Kinda like how simple this is. I'm afraid I'm gonna ruin it if I try to actually paint. New version coming up. I mean, this is out right now. You can download this. It's at the link in the description. It is done for desktop, at least. What I've been doing lately is just testing on desktop and then rolling out to mobile stuff later. Just because desktop is so much easier to fix stuff. Oh shit. Weird. See, I'm already screwing this up. Has Alberto tried it? Oh man, somebody was asking that the other day. I snuck it to him one time when we were having lunch, and he did a little painting of his girlfriend, and I don't think he liked it. I mean, he was using his... What was he doing? But I hope he'll give it another shot at some point. I think he would like it if he got used to it. Although there's not really any masking in here. I think that was his complaint, is that you need like some kind of lasso masking stuff. But I mean, you kind of have it with the fill tool. Is sort of a lasso. Let me actually—I forgot about fill lasso. Actually, let's try it. So So, like, what you don't blend? What? Hello, Sisyphus. Thanks for the kind words. Brody's asking what the playlist is. I think it's in the description, right? Can anybody... Am I crazy? Are these links not in the description? Guys? No? What if you don't blend? Then it's not blended. That's fine. You can do that. Do whatever you want. Description is empty? Oh shit. Sorry guys, my fault. Let me... Why is there no description? No! Oh god, okay, sorry. I have to put this in real quick. HeavyPoly.com, that's where you download the heavy paint. And then the playlist is called Painting in the Apocalypse. Let me share it. Playlist link. It's a Spotify playlist if anybody's into that business. Okay, there it is. Okay, these shadows underneath the eyeballs are really very juicy, actually. By juicy, I mean red, like saturated, deep, rich. Like, if you put black shadow in there, it's gonna kill it. So, just... the juicy shadow, man. Oh, yeah, there it is. Very juicy. And then... sort of blends to be darker on this side. And then closer to black down at the end. There we go. Beautiful. No, actually no, not beautiful. There, that's it. See, now I'm thinking, like, about how lazy I'm being with the colors. I'm not really changing the colors enough. Because there's a stat for that. So now I'm self-conscious about it. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but if it makes me pick more colors, I'm happy. Ooh, this song. Oh, can we turn this up? Let's see. Do you paint better with no music? I really need music for painting. But I can't do programming with music though. I kinda need silence for programming. let's keep it abstract. To be too uptight. Yeah, Manu knows. The keyboard. Oh yeah, I'm showing off my keyboard tonight. This is a... what do you call it? Niz Plum. I like it because it's really quiet. Well, it's not super quiet, but it's quiet for a mechanical keyboard. Play StarCraft. That's it. oh yeah, Overwatch is fun too. Mixing is cheating. Lazy, 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 lazy. Let's see. The bottom of the claw gets this green into it. really dark green, actually. I feel like I shouldn't really render this. Oh god. Let's see. How can we make this, the bottom part here, sing? A little bit green, a little bit blue. Now it smells like doo-doo. I forgot I could zoom in. Shit. No, that's funny. The rake, the rake size doesn't change. I mean, like the tip width doesn't change. So it looks giant. Yeah. Figure that out eventually. I like the cleaner version. I'll try to keep it clean. Even though it's incorrect, I don't care. Don't care. Looking fresh, Mr. Hermit. Mr. Henry. Henry the Hermit Crab. Herbert. Hubert. Ian Hubert, right? You can call him Ian. Mr. Hubert. Looks like a strawberry, totally. I think this is actually called a strawberry crab. Yeah, strawberry crab. Am I squinting when I paint? No, not really. It's Mooshell.
Hello, Mooshell.
Is there a way in Heavy Paint to import a picture? Oh god, I really shouldn't tell you guys this, but let me see. It's hidden right now, but you can't tell anyone. This is hidden. See right here? Import image. This is just in added to the latest version, but it's hidden. Do not tell anyone. Just you use it. That's it. So take a screenshot. Or actually, don't take a screenshot. whatever. Didn't I add it to the description? No? It should be in the description. The playlist. I don't... Man, the stupid YouTube descriptions are so annoying. I'm gonna have to figure this out later. I don't know if it's working properly. Okay. No worries. Welcome, welcome. Anybody that's new here, I guess, we're using this little program called Heavy Paint. I've been working on it for the past year. Oh, over a year, actually. For the past over a year. And I think it's getting pretty good lately. I'm pretty excited about the new stuff. And hopefully by just watching me use it a little bit, you can see, get an idea of like what it's about. It's kind of all about just really basic colors and shapes and doing that with as little friction as possible. And there's lots and lots of little, like, tiny, cool Easter eggs and features, at least I think, that people have been finding little by little. And it's basically got all the stuff that I've always wanted to have in a painting program, but finally got to work on my own version, I guess. This guy is looking very fancy. Let's see. Yeah, and also it's free, so if you want to try it, just go to the link, download it, it's free. Throw it out if you don't like it. But I hope you'll give it a shot. I think it's pretty different. I should do that more. I don't really like... I need to nail down my spiel. I think usually other people describe it better than I do. And plus, I feel really cheesy whenever I talk it up, you know? It's extra lame. I need to stop. Yeah, it's just, you know. Try to make this a little bit brighter. And it goes all the way up. This purple's doing pretty well here. So my plan is to just render the crap out of this central area and then leave the rest of it really loose. I think that'll be pretty cool in the end. Just like as a contrast. Or maybe not render the crap out of it. That looks horrible. Okay, the paddle back here, totally, that's like full strawberry. That's so cool. Oh wait, but we said we're gonna leave that really loose, huh? Maybe just get general. Well, the middle should definitely be bright white. So let's maybe get that going. Hello, Ben. Hey, Alex. Yeah. It's a good little break. That's a good way to put it. Emilio, thank you. You have any suggestions? What would make it better? Try doing a low poly model of the crab and then projecting it. I think that would be really cool, actually. A little chunky critter. That would be pretty fun. Might have to do that someday. How basic do we want to go over here? Just full basic? Might be cool, actually. I kind of like this shape. I mean, it's so stupid and chunky. It's really charming, I think. I'll leave it. Started watching Star Trek last night for the first time. I don't know why I never saw it. It was always on TV, but I never really... I think I watched it a little bit as a kid, but I never... I didn't know what was going on. Maybe I was too dumb to understand what was happening. It was pretty goofy. I like it so far. And Patrick Stewart is being a hard ass to everybody. It's fun. It's like, make it so. Excellent. I wish I could just say make it so to everyone. Like, sir, do you want fries with that? Like, make it so. Make it so. So where they encounter 2D beings. It's a good brainstorm. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's what I'm watching, I think. I'll look out for the 2D beings. I think that's one of the only things I remember from my childhood is like, I mean, like when I was in, not even elementary school, even I just remember all the kids' parents from in school, like all the kids' parents were Trekkies, and they and also everyone at that time was like parking their cars with the nose out, like forwards. That was a big thing. Those are the only two things I remember from the 90s. Everybody was parking their minivans backwards for some reason. And also, my friend's dad used to eat doggy treats, like doggy treats as a snack when we're watching Star Trek. I don't know, man. It's weird times. I tried it. It tastes like cardboard, or not like cardboard. It tastes like whole grain cereal a little bit. It wasn't too bad. People had mullets. I remember Trekkie parents with mullets and parking their cars backwards. And I also remember really hating Barney. And also, I really hated that song from the Lamb Chops, the ending of Lamb Chops show, that stupid song, never ending song. It used to drive me crazy. Doggy treats with milled bones and blood? What? What are you talking about, man? Is that a dish? Do you have doggy treat recipe book or something? Are you like the Gordon Ramsay of... What do you call those? I don't know. It's It's kind of green over here, actually. Green. What's in them? Oh, I didn't know that. Okay. Well, it tastes like whole wheat. Tasted organic. It wasn't very salty. In fact, it was like no salt, no taste at all. Super bland. But then that must mean dog food. I think I tried dog food too. The treat wasn't that much better than the dog food though. Okay, simpler. Maybe it's not any better, it's just different from the dog food, so they're like, oh wow, this is something that's not dog food. I want to eat this. You know? I hope you guys weren't coming here to try to like learn how to paint or anything like that. Whatever makes you strong, just hold on. Just hold on. Just hold on. Just hold on. It's been a long time waiting. Too many friends have gone. No! I'm overdoing it here, aren't I? This is way too much rendering. Our original plan was to just render a little bit in the middle and let the other stuff kind of go on its own. Although I like this like red reflection that's coming along the rim. Try that. Hello, ZZ. Hey, Didi. Welcome back. Tried dog food and it was bad. Maybe with milk. Yeah, dog food is very much like cereal, I guess. Like, the way it sounds, hitting a bowl and all that. The fact that you pour it into a bowl. Oh yeah, I got a playlist in the description now. Oh man, this song. You guys remember this from the Gran Turismo commercial? Gran Turismo 4? I think I'm over rendering again, which it looks cool, but it's also ruining, it's making this look so out of place that it's like ridiculous. So maybe I need to go back in and just make this simpler. Simpler. How about that? I wonder if it's a good idea to add option of always on top. Yeah, I think that would be nice. I wonder if there is a way to do that. I'll look into that. Did I learn about photography? Yeah, it seems like all the good painters also have cameras and they like to do a lot of videos and pictures and stuff. I missed you, Chili Dog, thank you. And Sharf Dean, thank you, sir or ma'am. I missed a bunch of messages, oops. How much of your time is split between programming and painting? I think nowadays it's like 90% programming and a little bit of painting. Like, and when I do paint, I try to do a stream, so when you guys see me on here, that's like my only painting time. It's not too much, but it's okay. because other people are doing good paintings with heavy paint, so I kind of just live vicariously through you guys. I actually hate it. Summer's too hot. I'm not a fan of summer. I definitely like winter. Okay, let's see. Should I do the little polka dots? The dots, are they stupid? I don't know if I'll like it with the dots. More without the dots. Oh man, have we heard this song too many times on the stream, guys? Give me a thumbs up if you've heard this song before on the stream. Nuclear wall. And you're sick of it. Nuclear wall. I'm still not sick of it, but I know we've heard this a few times. Quite a few times, actually. Talking about nuclear wall. It's a motherfucker. Don't you know? Coronavirus. Coronavirus. They're talking about the pandemic. Okay. Don't you know? Motherfucker. Don't you know? Okay, what about these little tentacle things? Let's put some size. Oops. What is that? Well, yeah, winter, definitely like a cold winter. I wouldn't want that. It depends where you are. I grew up in Florida and summer is horrible. Winter is really nice. But I guess if you're like somewhere cold, then winter's way worse than summer. Okay, that's probably the coldest, one of the coldest places, huh? Radiation. Where are you, Didi, again? Rio. Yeah, okay. Pretty damn tropical. What you gonna do? I don't know, man. What are you gonna do? You know, I never thought about that. Is it better without the shadow or with the shadow, guys? This dark shadow over here. With or without? Without, huh? Yeah, I think so. Without, right. Another feature idea, how about 3 or 4 different brush sizes as buttons somewhere beside the brush state area? The purpose is limit brush size. Oh, interesting. Maybe. Could be. Just like traditional tools. Interesting idea. I will write it down. Think about it. Have you guys ever heard of this? I just started using this thing called Workflowy. It's awesome. You can do like this, and then you go in here, and then you can add like, oh, let's say there's a 6 pixel, and a 12 pixel, 32 pixel, 128 pixel, and then you go back, and then this, you go like that, and then you could like move it like that. It's really nice. You can have multiple cards. What else am I working on? Layers. JK. But not really. And then you can put, you can change this into, from a board into bullets, and then it becomes like a text document. And you can dig into things and add more things. It's like infinite nesting. And then you go in here, and then you go do-do-do-do-do, it's awesome. Workflowy, guys. Let me turn it back into a board. And you can put boards inside boards. I just found that out today. So, let's see, we could convert this to a board. Wait, what? I don't know what I'm doing. Could you call on Lady Day? It's better. It's more than Trello though, because it you can also have it like this, bullets, and you can have a board inside of bullets. It's more flexible. You can have like list within list within list, and go infinitely into like dig deeper and deeper. It's pretty cool. Okay, I think this is, what I'm finding now is that the more I touch it, the worse it gets, so I think it might be done, almost. Right? I think. I'm happy. I'm happy with him. Thanks, Dee Dee. Yeah. I don't know why I'm adding this color back here. I think it looks cool. I think this is done. We just give it one more color between here. Thank you, Countdown. Okay. Oh no, am I ruining it? hard to get these silhouettes without the without screwing up the background. This nice loose background that I had. Oh well. Let me turn off the size pressure thing. It's kind of screwing me up here. See ya, Didi. ZZ says, I have a weird question. You say you are a magician of painting and modeling, so you have many tricks and secrets. If you can unveil one, what do you want to share? Because of your BM? What is BM? What do you want to share? Oh, I know. My favorite trick right now is go here, go say parkour mode, and that takes away the eyedropper. And then you get to pick colors. I'm ruining this. I'm gonna leave it alone. Yeah, I'm ruining it. So let's go up here. Let's say export and crab Hubert. Whoa, 12,000. No, thank you. Maybe 3,500. Let's see. Export HP Hubert. And then let's check the stats. Let's see. Hubert is 208 chisel. And then fill. And then fill lasso. 161 colors picked. Not that many. I mean, it's pretty monotone. Just red and teal a little bit. But. Hubert, very cute. Oh wait. It's a hot mess when you zoom in, but that's how I like it. Can you show us our first painting? Yes, let's do it. I'm actually pretty happy with my first painting on this one. I got lucky with it. Wait, let me save this one more time. Hubert. Export image, Hubert. All right, the first time I used this was on a trip to Joshua Tree, which is a desert park. It's a really cool park. If you guys have never heard of it, it has these weird things. They're like cactuses that look like trees, called Joshua Trees. They look like Dr. Seuss designed a tree, or God was drunk that night or something, I don't know. But they're really cool. And there's these rocks, these really weird looking rocks everywhere. Joshua Tree rocks. It looks like this. They're all like stacked on top of each other. And it's sort of weird looking because they look like they were stacked by a giant being just playing with these boulders. But I guess the idea is like the soft parts of the rock eroded away, and then that left behind these bits, these harder bits behind. Anyway, let's look for the painting. It's in my archives somewhere. But yeah, painted Joshua Tree. That the version at this point had no undo. It had no eyedropper. It had no nothing. There was only like three tools, I think. Let me see. I can paint. I'm curious to see what date this was, because this would have been Joshua Tree. Where are you? Oh, actually, was that the first one? This also was really. Oh fuck. Where's the pictures? You know what? It's probably easier if I just go on Instagram, because I post everything on Instagram. So let's go back in time. Is there a way to skip in time on Instagram, I wonder? Yeah, a lot of paintings. Oh my god, I'm getting sick. I'm getting dizzy. Ah, there it is. This is one of the first ones. You can see the interface looks all different. This is one of the first ones, and also one of the ones that I was having a really hard time painting this on another app because of all the rectangles everywhere. It was driving me crazy because every time you want to make a rectangle, it was like a whole process. So I just wanted a tool that you could just drag rectangles super fast. So that was one of the first ones. This one. This is Joshua Tree. Testing my painting app at Joshua Tree. Being able to save more than one project. I was so scared because I had like just finished saving like right before we left for the trip, and I wasn't sure if it was gonna work. So I took a screenshot and I was like, shit. I think the file got corrupted, but look at that. There's only three tools in this version. But it looks pretty similar. That's 65 weeks. Over a year. May 12th, 2019. Yep. And that's the first one, right? Oh, no. Here's the first one. date is this? 71 weeks. Where's the first one? This is not heavy paint. This is Infinite Painter, I think. Pretty cool program. Yeah, I really like that Infinite Painter had a lasso tool, so I was using it just for that. Alright, time for me to go. Anyway, have a good rest of your day, everybody, or night. Thanks for joining in. Okay. See you guys next time. Bye.